Okay, so you talked a lot about the failures of socialism and the horrors that they've created, but you seem to have also left out a lot of the horrors of capitalism over the years, not including but not limited to the destruction of native land and stealing of their land, slavery, the colonialization of Africa, disasters such as the Triangle Fire back in the early 1900s, and continuous inequality today. And I want to know, is that a conscious decision that you're making in order to further your agenda, or if like you actually do believe that those things aren't actually tied to capitalism?
Okay, so let's look at some of the things that you mentioned. You mentioned, for example, you mentioned colonialism, you mentioned the destruction of native land, and you mentioned slavery. Let me just take those three. Those are like your three kind of slam dunk examples. Now, let's look at them one by one and ask this question. What does this have to do with capitalism? Not, are we living in a capitalist world, and so obviously every institution is going to have some relationship to capitalism, I admit that, just like it has to have some relationship to democracy, to monarchy, to whatever political regimes exist. But here's the point. Slavery. If I'm going to grab another guy and force him to work for free, do you consider that to be capitalism? Is that what Adam Smith talked about in The Wealth of Nations?
If it's in the pursuit of profits, absolutely. Which that's what capitalism was putting forward, and
So you got to go back.
Why slavery was installed in this country?
Okay. So to be fair, in all these things, you have to judge an idea by examining its validity on the behalf of the people who advocate it, right? If I'm gonna discuss Christianity, I'm gonna go to the words of Jesus Christ, I'm gonna go to the New Testament, right? I'm not gonna say, oh, I don't care about any of that. But so with capitalism, the simple fact of it is, if you don't have a voluntary workforce in which buyers and sellers and producers and consumers and workers and entrepreneurs are not in voluntary relations to each other, signing contracts and agreeing. The beauty of capitalism is that both sides are better off. Let's say, for example, take something really simple, okay? You have a glass of milk and I have $3, okay? And I say, I'd like to have your glass of milk. And you say, I'll sell it to you for $2, okay? Now, you would never do that. I'm not answering the question. I'm saying that colonialism, which is political conquest by force, and slavery, which is physical conquest of another man's labor, are the antithesis of capitalism. The forcible seizure of native land, none of this has anything to do with capitalism. It's the very opposite of capitalism.
So what you're saying is the United States of America was not a capitalist country until 1865, and that's the day it did?
I'm not saying that. I'm saying that the Southern economy was essentially a non-capitalist economy. Its champions knew that. The defenders of slavery all attacked capitalism.
But
they hated
capitalism. It was in the pursuit of profit, which has continued on since then through the Jim Crow law eras, since the establishment of private prisons. And it's, you know, it's happening to this day. It hasn't changed. It's been capitalism since this country has been founded, and that capitalism is rooted in the slavery of this country.
The dictator of Venezuela, Maduro, right? When he died, he was a billionaire. So he was obviously in pursuit of profit. He was a socialist who was looting the country for himself. Was he a capitalist because he cared about profit? No, because capitalism is not just about caring about profit. Capitalism is about a certain way of going about business that actually mutually enriches all the parties involved. Otherwise, they don't do the transaction. If I go to apply for a job at a company, and let's just say they offer to pay me $1 an hour, right? And let's just say, that's scandalous, that's slavery wages. If I don't take the job, I'm no worse off than I was before. They haven't exploited me in any way. They're offering me a deal, I'm free to take it or not. It's completely different if they go grab me, put a chain around my neck and make me work. That's the opposite of capitalism. That's why, read Lincoln. Lincoln says slavery is you work, I eat. And the alternative for him is the hand that makes the corn gets to put the corn in its own mouth. For Lincoln, that's capitalism.
So
you keep the fruit of your own labor.
So you're saying is the workers who produce the corn should be the ones who get that profit. So I guess we agree on that.
No, I'm saying if I come to a barren field that nobody has thought of cultivating, and I say, you know what? I actually see this as a very rich place to have avocados. And I hire 100 people to work on the avocados, and I pay them an agreed upon wage of, let's just say, $10 an hour. And at the end of it, I make $1 million, I would say that is a fair and just outcome because all of them agreed to the $10 an hour. It was well worth it for them, otherwise they wouldn't have done it. And I thought of the idea and I put it together.
Yes, I agree.